How's it going, guys? Nicholas Marcin here, and it is good to see another face, even if that is just a camera lens I'm talking to. But anyway, the Galaxy S20 came out last month, and we're seeing some discounts upwards of $500 for the phone, which is pretty good because when it first came out, it was really, really expensive. It's still pretty expensive. But $500 off is pretty good. So if you're looking for a Galaxy S20, how different really is it from the Galaxy S10? And that's what we're gonna find out, because there are some differences between them. All right, let's get the obvious out the way. The Galaxy S20 is bigger than the Galaxy S10 in every way. It is taller, it is heavier, it is a bigger screen. They're bigger. But one thing that you may not know is that the width of the phones aren't actually that much different. And this is a Galaxy S20 Plus. So I was kind of concerned going from the regular S10 to the S20 that it would feel a little bit unwieldy in my hands. But actually, like I said, the width between the two phones are insignificantly different, actually. So Samsung was able to achieve this by not making the phone any wider, but making it taller. A lot of people don't know this, but they actually measure the screen size diagonally. So from this point to this point is over 6 inches, not the entire surface of the display itself. So yes, it is bigger than this phone, but it's not much wider. So it's pretty easy to hold, which is really good. Another obvious difference is the camera placement. On this phone, the camera placement is to the right of the phone. This time it's to the center. I've always had some weird looking pictures of people looking sort of to the side while they're taking a picture because they don't know that the camera is to the side of the phone, not to the center, and they're just looking at themselves. And so, yeah, you do get that. That is fixed with this one being on the center. But in addition to that, you also get some less digital bezels, and I'll show you what that is. If you jump into an app like Apple Music, you'll see at the top of the display, you get this sort of digital bezel that's trying to hide the camera. Not all apps are full screen optimized for the Galaxy, and Apple is one of those cases for obvious reasons. So you get this big, really fat bezel on the top here. When you're looking at the S20, that bezel is significantly reduced, and you can see that there very easily. I'll zoom in. Now, I hear a lot of reviewers saying that the Galaxy S20 camera is the same as the one on the S10, and it does sound that way, but it's not. Yes, while it is true, the Galaxy S10 and the S20 camera both have a 26mm front-facing camera. They're both 10 megapixels each. That is true, but it is different when you take into account aperture. The Galaxy S20's aperture is f2.2, and the Galaxy S10 is f1.9, so theoretically, the F10 has a better low-light camera than the S20 does. So that sounds like a downgrade there, but really, how does that translate in terms of pictures? So here you go, I have a picture here. I am in a low light situation. As you can see, yes, the S10 is brighter than the S20 is, but if you zoom in just a little bit, you'll see that, yeah, the S20 is far sharper than the S10. And you have much better HDR, high dynamic range, than the S10 does. And that's just because of new processors in the S20. It is overall a better image. Now, while it is true, if I get into an even darker situation than that picture, and I get into some really dark rooms, the S20 will not do as good as the S10. But really, why are you taking a picture in that much of a dark atmosphere? If you are, just switch night mode on and that will solve all your issues. Now, how does night mode fare on the S10 versus the S20? It is obviously better on the S20. As you can see, we're getting the same thing, S10, brighter, not a sharper image. Okay, let's talk about things that I don't see people covering. And we'll start off with something that's not super important, is the vibration motor. Yeah, that sounds fun, right? Well, back in the day in the Galaxy S8, we had a sort of a taptic engine in the Galaxy S8. A taptic engine is the word that Apple coined when they introduced it for the iPhone 7 with that home button that you press that wasn't actually a physical home button. It just vibrated your phone to feel like one. Didn't make sense. But the Galaxy S8 took it a step further. They put the home button in the screen itself. You press hard on the screen, you force touch it, and it vibrates your phone, feeling like a home button. Really cool. Ever since then, when they removed that, you know, digital home button, you don't get a taptic engine in the phones anymore. So ever since, they've been using a regular vibration motor. This time with the S20, they brought it back. There is a full taptic engine or haptic engine in the S20, and it's really good. It's better than the S8, and it's just as good as the cream of the crop iPhone. iPhone does a really good job with their haptic engines, and this one is just as good. Now, obviously, you're not going to go buy a Galaxy S20 because they changed the vibration motor. You don't hear people saying, oh, you've got that. vibration motor, you peasant. I've got a Taptic engine, right? You don't really hear that. But it is something, it is a marginal improvement from last generation, and it's a good addition. Now, we all know that the Galaxy S20 has the same fingerprint sensor as the one in the S10, and that's a known fact, everybody says it, but they moved it this time around in a more ergonomic location. But the fingerprint sensor, if we zoom in, you'll see that they brought the fingerprint sensor a lot higher than they did on the S10. Now, that may seem not like a big deal, but when you place your finger on the phone, it naturally goes to the way where the S20 is. It's a little bit lower on the S10, so I've got to sort of stretch my fingers just a little bit down. It's obviously marginal, but it's one of those things I could just pick up my phone and unlock it without really even looking at the phone. I just know naturally where my thumb is gonna land, and I've only had this phone for 1 week. All right, now let's talk about the speakers of the phone. The S20 is louder than the S10 is. And what's funny is that the S20's front-facing speaker is significantly smaller. If I zoom in, you'll see I can run my nails over the S10 speaker. You can very clearly see that. But on the S20, it's actually very tough to even see where the front-facing speaker is. There's a little slither right on the bezel where the front-facing speaker of the S20 is. But the drivers and everything is actually under the display of the S20. So it is louder, and it is less seen on the S20 than it is on the S10. So they did a really good job with the speakers here. All right, now let's talk about the S20's internals. You've got more RAM, obviously. The S10 had 8 gigabytes of RAM. This one's starting at 12 gigabytes of RAM, so you've got almost double. So what does that really mean? Well, you're really never gonna run out of RAM here. You'll always have apps running in the background. In fact, you can lock apps. So for me, if I swipe up, I've always got my Tesla app open, which means, it's always up and running. I can always click on that and change something for the car. Even if I close all here, you'll see it's still there. In addition to that, you're getting 25 watts of fast charging. So you're getting 10 watts more fast charging than the S10 was, which was at 15 watts, which means it's gonna be a bigger battery on your S20s, but it's gonna charge at just as much time, if not faster, than you would have in the smaller battery S10, which is really, really cool. In addition to that, the screens are not only bigger, we all know that you get 120 hertz, they're gonna fix it where you can do 120 hertz, 1440p in the next update, so that's gonna be great. It's gonna kill battery a little bit more, but you choose whatever you want. But yeah, not only are the screens bigger and you've got that really cool 120 hertz display, but they're actually even brighter and even sharper. The S20 is getting 1,342 nits at its peak brightness, which means it's about 10% brighter than the S10 gets outside. And even though this is a bigger screen, it gets a higher PPI percentage than the S20. A lot of phones, they make the screen bigger at the same resolution, which drops the PPI, but here you're getting slightly more resolution, which means you're getting slightly more pixels per inch. On the S20, you're getting 563 PPI. On the S10, you're only getting 550. So you're getting a bigger screen, sharper screen, brighter screen. It's a better screen. And lastly, let's talk about cameras one more time, since that is the headline feature of these phones. Let's talk about the zoom camera on this one. We know that the ultra cameras, they have these 100x space zoom, right? If you get the regular S20 or the S20 Plus, no, you don't get the space zoom, but the regular S20 and the S20 Plus does give you 3x hybrid zoom. So you get, it's a mixture of digital and optical, but it is optical technically. So the way they do it is the telephoto lens on this camera is 48 megapixels, right? The regular S10 has a 10 megapixel zoom telephoto camera. This one's 48 megapixels. So when you zoom in the picture, which is technically optical, if you zoom into the picture digitally, it is naturally a sharper image. So you can go up from 3x, 4x, 10x, all the way up to 30x, whereas the S10 camera is capped at 10x. Take a look at this. Here is a 5x photo taken with the S20. Here's a 5x photo taken with the S10. And if I zoom in, you're getting far more detail on the S20 with that 48 megapixel camera. So it's not all about the camera with this phone. You do get a bigger display, a brighter display, better speakers, you get more RAM, more internals, more storage. You get a lot more here, everything that's pretty much talked about. I know vibration motors isn't pretty cool, but you get that too. Well, there you have it, guys. Please be safe during this terrible, terrible year, and you have a good one.